time.
Better, or what am I going to do with all this? Finally! You supposed to be here 15 minutes ago.
Sorry, I slept in, and then my sister took forever to eat her breakfast, but whatever, we're here now.
It's okay, we're glad you're here. Ready to do this?
We're ready.
Alright, let's go.
All right, you girls can go through. Looking a little glassy-eyed this morning, huh, miss?
No, I'm just tired.
Just tired? Why don't we just have Rex here have a little sniff-sniff of your bag? What do you think about that?
Okay, I guess.
Come on, boy, search out that contraband. Come on, get it. Come on, come on, come on. Look, 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 look. Come on, search it.
Looks like you're clean. Make sure it stays that way. Next. Well, well, well. Did you miss the memo, Sparky? No blades allowed.
But those are children's scissors. I didn't think that they would be banned.
Do you make a habit of arguing with an officer of the law? Assume the position. Suppose you didn't know about the binder rule, huh?
I've been honestly using this binder all year and nobody said anything.
Just look at these things, it's common sense. These things are like crocodile teeth. You take out an eye with one of these. You like that, huh?
No.
Point made, case closed.
But my chemistry homework is in there.
Let that be a lesson you point, Dexter. Crime doesn't pay. Move along. Next.
Good morning, officer. Can't believe those kids trying to fool you like that. It's just shameful.
Are you Brock Manley? Didn't you used to play football here?
Yes, I did a few years back, actually.
Oh my god, I told you, Olivia. You were the kicker, right? I'm glad I get to meet you in person. Can we get a picture with you?
I'm sorry, I can't. I'm on duty right now.
Oh, pretty please. Come on, just one little picture. I'll be so grateful.
Well, I guess one quick snapshot couldn't hurt.
Darn, Olivia, you blinked. Okay, you get in. You get in. Ready?
I'm stuck.
What?
My sister brace.
Okay.
Thank you so much. I'm gonna be the envy of all my friends.
No problem. Why don't you girls just go on ahead?
Thank you, officer.
Please, just call me Brock. Oh wait, hold on one second, gentlemen. You guys almost caught me flat-footed there. I didn't search your bag. And looky here. You guys have the exact same notebook with the staples removed. Good to see you guys are following the school rules. Have a nice day.
That was so close. Gina and Olivia did good, though.
Yeah, I guess.
They saved their asses.
I still think we paid too much.
You gotta spend money to make money, partner.
If you spend less money, we make more money.
Quit being such a cheap bastard. All right, everybody, the Forbidden Fruit Stand is open for business. What can I get for you, sir?
Could I have some flavored tortilla chips, please?
Sure, that'll be $1. What about for you, ladies? How about some sour gummies? They're just the kick you need to get through those third period hunger pangs.
Sure.
It's $1.50.
They were $1 last week.
Well, you know the school and their, no unhealthy snacks rule. It's kind of making it difficult to keep a lid on the prices. You know how much it costs to smuggle those through security? But if you're not happy with our prices, you can shove those gummies in your gitch and smuggle them through yourself.
I'll have Coke.
Iggy, my man. I saw what's happened this morning. Tough break.
Yeah, I know. My grade point average is totally screwed.
Borrow me.
And there you are. Pleasure doing business with ya. Hey, what's up?
Iggy, Mita, Iggy.
Nice to meet you.
Iggy here could use our help.
Sure, what do you need?
Grade 11 chemistry, Miss Gladstone.
I think we can help you there. Let's see. Chemistry, Gladstone. What's the subject?
Organic acids.
Ooh, don't have that one. I have transformation of alkenes. Am I saying that right? And then I have natural and synthetic polymers. Iggy, my boy, listen to me. These are both A papers, and Miss Gladstone, just between the two of us, she can barely remember where her parking stall is. She won't remember these old papers, if that's what you're worried about. That'll be $10. Thanks.
Yep.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Yep. Skittles, please.
Sorry, man. Closed for the day. Come back next period. Holy crap, that was nuts. We're gonna need to restock for tomorrow.
Are you kidding? I was thinking we should lay off for a couple of days.
Business is booming. Why we lay off now? These kids, they depend on us. We make their lives better. Besides, a couple minutes ago, weren't you complaining about not making enough money?
Yeah, but if the school finds out, my mom will kill me.
If the school finds out? Like Principal Pritchard? He's so dumb. Couldn't even pour piss out of a boot if the directions were written on the heel. He doesn't even know the recipe for ice. Get this one. This one's really funny. Principal Pritchard was fired from the M&M factory for throwing away all the W's. Shit. Mr. Pritchard, I think there's been a slight misunderstanding.
Excuse me, Ralph. I don't recall giving you permission to speak. Speak.
Sir, I was thinking. You've got us dead to rights. No question about that. Now, the candy issue is something I'm in total agreement on. Tooth decay, childhood obesity. These are huge problems. Kids should be thankful. They have teachers and parents setting limits. Limits, we understand, which are simply for their own good. But the problem, sir, is that we have some youngsters who have developed a dependence on these greasy, sugary snacks. It's not the world we made, it's the world we inherited. These kids, they want to kick the habit, sir, they do. But it's hard. And that's where we come in. We know that you can't just cut out the junk cold turkey. We carefully monitor our customers' buying habits. We work to wean them off of their candy addiction. Didn't I stop little Abigail Sullivan from buying that jumbo licorice value pack? Yes. Yes, I did. And instead, I sold her a low-cal chocolate pudding. And she was grateful. As a matter of fact, I saw her in the cafeteria, happily munching away on some celery sticks. We're in the same battle, Principal Pritchard. We're on the same team. We totally accept responsibility for these reprehensible actions. But there is a silver lining in this, Jim. May I call you Jim? These incidents, they show a certain spark in the individuals involved. So I think we can see some real gumption, some initiative. And in some ways, it's quite admirable. So, wrong's done, yes. Lessons learned, most certainly. So what do we do now, Jim? What's the best course of action? I think that this whole situation will be best handled with a firm warning. I think that's the best action, Jim. So, are we done here, Jim?
You kids need to learn a thing or two about being responsible and having respect.
Nice going. You just made it matter. 2 months detention?
I'm so dead.
It was worth a shot.
I didn't even know that binders were crocodile teeth.
Olivia, why'd you choose that one?
Scientific curiosity.
My life is over.
Don't be so dramatic, Iggy. This'll all blow over.
Since when is detention held in the library?
Since it was decided to put you to work. Rather than just sitting, staring into space.
Miss Boxer, so they made you our Jira, eh?
So what's the plan? Teaching us how to shelve books?
I've always wanted to learn the Dewey Decimal System.
No, nothing as fun as that. This is our storage area. I want you to go through all this stuff, dust and catalog everything, and make it nice and neat. And when that's done, we have some other chores for you, like cleaning the desks and computers.
You mean like cleaning your browser history, Miss Boxer?
You need to finish by 4:30. Have fun.
I think she meant to dust the computers, Ralph.
Old books smell. I'd rather be cleaning out a gas station bathroom.
Or as I like to call it, Grandpa's house.
I'm just glad that my mom packs this dust mask and this dust suit in my lunch bag.
And rubber gloves. Look at her. And dental floss.
And condoms? What the hell, Iggy?
Hey, that's not true.
Look at this stuff. It looks like scuba gear and film.
There's a projector right over there.
I've always wanted to try a projector.
Well, today's your lucky day, Iggy.
Underwater knife fighting club?
Underwater knife fighting. Fighting's blocked.
Try underwater knife competition.
Knife's blocked.
Oh, try underwater utensil competition.
Underwater's blocked.
Really?
Well, it is related to drowning.
How about not on ground utensil competition?
There it is, underwater knife fighting. Underwater knife fighting was a sport that was popular in Canada and the USSR in the years following World War II.
What else does it say?
It says, the sport briefly became underwater spoon fighting after an incident at the Canada-USSR International Competition in Winnipeg, Manitoba in 1976.
Incident?
As a result, the sport lost popularity and was eventually abandoned as a whole.
Hey guys, I fixed the projector.
Careful, Jink.
Thanks.
If Miss Boxer sees that, she's gonna flip.
Nah. Miss Boxer, I understand. She was one of our best customers.
It's true. She has an extreme jujube addiction. Quite sad, really. Jujube?
Sure.
Movie time!
Excitement, danger, athletic prowess, knives. Canada's youth are rediscovering a legendary sport with a venerable tradition, and its name is underwater knife fighting.
Hi, I'm George Stevens. You may remember me from my previous film, My Changing Body, A Journey Through Puberty. Welcome to Underwater Knife Fighting, a look into the lives of underwater knife fighters. Here we are at John Diefenbaker High School, where the top underwater knife fighting team in the country is preparing for finals next month. Let's go meet the team.
Every team is a star player, and for Diefenbaker High School's underwater knife fighting team, the Stinging Jellyfishes, Dax Baxter fills that role.
Yeah. Some people call me the backbone of the team. Do I believe them? Of course. Does that make me a little bit cocky? Absolutely. But how can you be the best if you don't think you're the best? You know, I've been the best at everything my whole life. Soccer, hockey, football, track.
My name is Sophia, and I'm an underwater knife fighter. I first started the sport back in Israel during the Yom Kippur War. secretly trained myself to defend my family in case they were in danger. One day, we were attacked by a small group of soldiers at our kibbutz on a Dead Sea, and I took care of them. Let's just say the Dead Sea got a little bit deader that day. Cucumber?
Karate, rocketry, racing, origami.
George, I've got this zit here. Could you maybe, like, not film from my left side?
Oh, no, that's okay. We can just pop it.
No, what about makeup or something? Like, would you want... maybe just don't film from the left side. You don't have to... Do you want to pop it?
Oh, hi, I'm Randy. I'm a member of the Diefenbaker's Underwater Knife Fighting Team. People often ask me, Randy, is it hard to have so many people look up to you? I say it isn't. In fact, the admiration and respect is the fuel that keeps me going. Oh, hi, Gabby.
Get lost, loser.
Why did you join the team?
Why did I join Underwater Knife Fighting Club? I don't know. I guess my dad did it, so I guess I'm just following in his footsteps. Flipper steps.
Cool, man.
Is that it, or okay? Do you want me to say more?
Guitar, lacrosse.
How do I even describe underwater knife fighting? When you're in the water, you just feel free. Feeling the resistance of the water against your skin as you dance with the knives, it's just all so majestic. And Dylan, he's kind of cute too.
Tell us about your father.
Well, my father died when I was pretty young, so I don't really know a lot about him, but I do have this one memory. It was Easter, and I guess my parents decided to hide some Easter eggs, so I went looking for them, and I stepped on this really big nail. It was really bad, but my father, he fixed me up, and then he died the next week in a knife competition.
Everyone knows about Dylan's dad. It's the reason why he's on the team. It's a way for him to connect with the father that he never knew, to understand him. I think it's a good thing that he's on the team.
Are you getting the birds? Can we do something about the damn birds?
Do I think we have a chance against the Russians? Chances don't matter. It's the outcome that matters. If the outcome's a win, then that's great. If the outcome's a loss, well, then I just wasted 3 years of my life on nothing. But life's full of disappointments. And if you learn to expect nothing, then those disappointments don't feel so bad.
As one can imagine, a lot of hard work and intense training goes into being an underwater knife fighter. To be a stinging jellyfish, you must be tough in body, mind, and spirit to be successful.
The most important quality a knife fighter's gotta have is fast reflexes. In this sport, the difference of victory and defeat is determined in milliseconds. A knife fighter's gotta be ready for anything. At all times.
How badly do you want this cheese, little mice? How hungry are ya?
Oh my God!
Guess you need to get a little bit more hungrier, Randy. My philosophy is, if training doesn't hurt, you're doing something wrong. I'm a firm believer that pain is the best teacher. 2 minutes! .220, keep going!
You know, if you don't win tomorrow, it's gonna look really bad for our movie. So maybe try and stay there just a little bit longer. You too.
Oh, cut the camera!
Great effort, Dylan. The ability to stay under longer than the enemy is good. Not if the reason is because you're dead. You know, it's nice every once in a while to play something different. Something you don't need to take too seriously. Hey, sweetheart. Let me show you how it's done. All you gotta do is it's all in your wrists.
That's okay, Dax. I've done this before.
Okay, baby.
זה מזכיר לי את הראש של חייל שאני שברתי עם כזאת אבן.
זה נחמד. יש לך PTSD. Yeah! Bocci! Woo! Yeah! Hey guys!
The sport of underwater knife fighting has a storied history. Its origins lie off the coast of northern France during World War II, when elite teams of Canadian frogmen were sent to scout the coast in preparation for the D-Day invasion.
After the war, the techniques and traditions were kept alive, and the Korean War saw these awful yet necessary methods put to use once again. Like the Germans before them, the evil communist enemy tried to match our brave Canadian fighters. Since then, underwater knife fighting evolved into a non-lethal form of competitive combat, popular among a special breed of Canadian teens, and it has become a tool of detente. Canucks, Soviets, and others, fearful of combat in a nuclear age, have now turned to non-lethal forms of competition.
So, what are the rules of this sport, born of combat and tamed by the necessities of the Cold War? They're quite simple. Each fighter has a float attached to his or her shoulder. The objective is to cut free your opponent's float and let it rise to the top. When it hits the surface, that is when the opponent is eliminated. Alternatively, if a fighter finds themselves in danger, they can cut free their own float to surrender. Technically, the rules do still allow for a fighter to win by incapacitating or even killing their opponent, but this is wildly frowned upon and has not occurred since 1962. Through all, the training, the bonding, the laughter, the tears. The team still remains focused on one goal, the underwater knife fighting championships. And with that competition away, all the fighters must remain focused. Yes, our intrepid knife fighters must prepare, but they will also use this time to savor the good things in life. Or else, what are they fighting for?
I don't waste my time relaxing. Relaxing is just another word for weakness. When I'm not training, my enemies are.
So, this is the lair.
Yeah, this is where I get mentally prepared. Pretty cool.
Pretty good collection of Farrah Fawcett posters you got.
Yeah, I've been collecting those for a while. In the days leading up to a big competition, I like to watch old underwater knife fighting films and TV shows. Sea Hunt, James Bond, stuff like that. The depictions are humorously inaccurate, but I like that. It relaxes me.
Floyd? The boss?
A good one, yeah.
Stones?
Oh, yeah.
Wings.
Come on, Band on the Run. You don't like Wings?
No, stop. Stop.
Fine. It's not your man zone.
To relieve stress before a big competition, I like to hang out with my friends.
So you don't believe in the notion that you should abstain from romance before a competition, you know, to maintain focus and energy?
Heck no.
So you'd be okay with Dylan and Tessa being on a date right now?
Say what?
Tessa and Dylan, they're on a date right now.
What?
One day until competition, things become quite tense as we learn that the Russians have been exploiting the still technically legal lethal tactics long abandoned by the other teams.
Okay guys, listen up. I've just read that the Russians have won the Eastern Bloc title. They're playing rough. They've gutted a Hungarian, lopped off a Czech's hand, and a German woman, or it might have been a man, was killed. Now they're not happy about America's new nuclear missile, so they're trying to send us a message that they won't be pushed around. What they're doing is technically legal, but we've got to be ready for them to come at us with the same stuff, if not worse.
So we're gonna forfeit, right? We haven't trained for real knife fighting.
You can quit if you want. I don't blame you, but I'm not quitting. Guys like these Soviets, they think we're weak. They think we're too polite.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
They think we've gone soft with our fancy cars and our TVs, but I know we haven't gone soft. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna let them win by default. But am I saying we're gonna stoop to their level? No. We're gonna win our way, play by our rules. Because we aren't killers, but we aren't soft. True North, strong and free. Isn't that what we sing every day? Well, do you believe it? I guess this competition is our chance to prove it, one way or another.
I don't wanna forfeit, I wanna fight them!
Yeah, me too.
And me.
I'll fight those goddamn commie bastards. I'm not afraid.
Kind of a point system. This is our
10 points, 20 points, 90 points. Now the difference is, sometimes during our games, we go like this and we go, and it's called a combo, and it's 240.
What's your impression of your Canadian opposition?
Your knife fighters are meh.
Hey guys, we got two of the best cameramen from the John Diefenbaker High School Film Club. And they've got special underwater cameras so that you won't miss a beat of the action.
There were some parts in there that I thought I was gonna be done, but...
Beat the crap out of her!
Word is that your opponent on the Russian team, Oleg, is the killer. What is your response to that?
Well, like, I mean, it's dangerous, but I'm just happy to be out here, showing off my country.
Sophia, what's happening? Your boyfriend's in trouble.
You can't.
I have to.
I say, children,
waste your time asking why. No one knows what's on the other side. Just like all things around you, it's the way it has to be. I see the cold seasons coming, I hear the funeral bells ring. But is the life of a man any more than the leaves? In the town that I call home, there is a tree, there's a weathered storm. Under the branches I have grown, all around it the people I have known. Like the seasons, I've seen them come and go. Drop the waves, the ones I love to know. But is the life of a man any more than the leaves? What is the life of a man any more than the leaves? What is the life of a man any more than the leaves? What is the life of a man any more than the leaves? I see the cold seasons coming, I hear the funeral bells ring. What is the life of a man any more than the leaves?
Well, shit. I guess that concludes underwater knife fighting. I'm George Stevens, and for the John Diefenbaker High School Film Club, see you again.
Shackles I made in the town.
good comes with the bad. It's all never just sad. There's hope, there's a silver line. Show me.